Isaac Newton told us that gravity was a force with which all objects with mass pulled on all other objects with mass.
Meaning that due to gravity, you're attracted to the Earth and every other object in your surroundings. Only you feel that attraction less with certain objects because the force of gravity is dependent on their mass and their respective distances.
Light, on the other hand, is massless, meaning Newton's gravitation predicts that light will not be gravitationally attracted towards any mass. Well, in 1915, Einstein challenged this idea and put forth some pretty neat ideas for it in his General Theory of Relativity.
His exploration of this theory starts when he has what he called his happiest thought.
He imagined a person falling from the roof of a building and he realized that person wouldn't feel gravity, just like someone in outer space. He also imagined somebody in space where there's no gravitational field in a closed box being accelerated upward. And after some thought, he reasoned that that person would still feel the effects of gravity. Constant acceleration meant his feet and everything along with him would be glued to the ground as if he were in a stationary box on the surface of the Earth.
So he deduced as what's known as the equivalence principle. The effects of gravity and acceleration are completely equivalent.
But what happens when we introduce light into our accelerating elevator? Well, picture it. Since the box is accelerating upwards, a ray of light traveling perpendicular to the direction of motion wouldn't travel across to the other end in a straight path. Instead, it would curve and bend down. And since we've established that the accelerating elevator and the stationary one are physically identical, then gravity has the same effect. It bends light. Now, ideas are one thing and the behavior of nature is another, and only when both meet do we say that we have an acceptable theory. Well, in 1919, Sir Arthur Eddington did just that. He took pictures of the sun and detected the light emitted by a group of stars that were known to be directly behind it. The gravity of the sun had bent their light, just like in our example. But if light is massless, then how does it feel the effects of gravity? Well, it turns out gravity must spring from a property of space-time.
Space-time had to no longer be considered as a place where events occurred, but as an active participant in these events, meaning that through its geometry, space-time influences events and vice versa. Essentially, mass deforms spacetime by modifying its geometry, and spacetime affects the behavior of objects, whether mass or massless. Picture it as follows. Imagine a two-dimensional plane as the universe. If a heavy ball is on the plane, which represents a large mass in space, it is deformed so that it is no longer flat. This means that if a light beam were to travel on it, the deformation of spacetime would make the beam follow a curved path, not a straight one. Gravity is therefore not a force existing between all objects, but a curvature that affects how they travel, causing light to bend. We became witnesses to the biggest leap of the scientific imagination in history, the theory of general relativity.